Hi, my name is Paula, and today I'll be explaining the procedures for setting up an IV piggyback and changing the patient's gown with the IV set up on their arm. So first we have to do our 7 steps. First we check the physician's orders, then we make sure our hands are washed. Then we set up all of our equipment. We make sure that we have the right patient. We introduce ourselves to the patient. We explain the procedure we're going to be doing with the patient, and we always provide for privacy. So the first thing we're going to do is the primary IV bag. We want to make sure that the end is sterile.
Putting over the primary IV. First you would do the patient's order and wash your hands. After you gather the equipment.
So same thing with the tubing. We want to make sure that the ends are always sterile.
If you see that I say that wrong, just come
out. You would also write a label of the saline.
We make sure our tubing is clamped.
Match the order for the patient's band. To put it up.
We always want to make sure that there is no rip on the bag, and we check the expiration date, make sure that we're not giving anything that requires the patient. Then we're going to prime the tubing, make sure that this ends always will stay sterile all the time.
We
fill the tubing about halfway up. Make sure we take all the air bubbles out. So we inspect the tubing for air bubbles.
Find your line.
Where does this pump that off at?
It's not there, so there's
then at this point we would connect it to our patient, but since our patient is a mannequin, we're not really able to do that, so we're going to set up the drip rate.
Then get alcohol
swab. The physician's orders call for 60 drops per minute, so we're just going to separate that into 15 drops every 15 seconds.
Your fun cap?
No, you're just maintaining the
Then the drops per minute were to be calculated when you review the medication. And as you unclamp it, before you unclamp it, you make sure the drip chamber is halfway full. Then you unclamp, and you make sure the drops coincide with the order. And that is for administrating IV.
Okay, now we're going to clamp it.
Oh, continue it?
There we go. We make sure that the port is sterile.
The second step we'll be reviewing is changing the patient's gown.
Now we would connect it.
And again, for this you have to wash your hands.
And at this point we would unclamp it, but again, since our patient is mannequin, we can't really do that. So now we're going to set up an IV piggyback.
It doesn't have the IV. Gather a clean gown.
This is basically the same procedure, but the secondary tubing and secondary IV have to go higher up than the primary one.
Take out the whole gown.
We want to make sure we have this.
I am now.
now. So this is the same. We want to make sure that this is sterile. Primary tubing, so we want to make sure that this is also sterile.
We want to make sure that there's
still the halfway up. Unclamp our tubing.
So I have about 30 feet. Everything looks good.
There's no air bubbles now, so we can connect it to the primary tubing. But before we do that, we want to make sure that this end is sterile.
And now, I'm going to pretend that I have a password here. I'm going to hold on to the password, or 30 seconds of the password, and I am going to block.
So now we want to make sure that we open it and then I'm going back to it. But this has to stay clamped.
Go over to the side without the ID.
And then we would regulate it with our primary tubing. So then with our mannequin, we want to make sure that this is again that there are no air bubbles in the tubing. And we would regulate the drip factor again.
As you take off the dirty gown, try to cover the patient again. Privacy is a very important factor.
I'm going to remove my glove.
Then
I'm going to come back and
make sure you hold it elevated. Put it inside the dirty gown. From outside in.
Thank you so much for that.
Okay, so that's 15 drops in 15 seconds as well.
Alright,
we want to clamp our tubing. And then again, we would clean the port. And then connect it to our patient. So now to take the patient down, change the patient's gown using their IV on their arm, first we would make sure that bed is at working height and then lower the side mount.
Another source of solution. back your original.
So we want to make sure we pass the entire gown through all the tubings and all the
artifacts.
Equipment.
Of course, you wash your hands.
Amount of comfort for our
patients. But this set is quite similar to the previous one. Let's do it again.
It's changed according to physician's orders. The same thing goes for the tubing. We have to make sure that we leave a label saying when it was changed and when it was administered. So now we would put back the gown, like a new gown for a patient, and it would be the same procedure.
Piggyback again, wipe the port with alcohol swab. And again, look at the making sure it coincides with the physician's order.
I wanted to, like, kill her.
You wash your hands and leave the room. After you come back, see if the piggyback solution
has
finished its course. You then clamp the solution. And you see you put the original solution elevated again. And then you see the drops per minute of the original solution is again
coincide
with the original order. And that's the step for coming back in here.
We have the patient in a comfortable position with a call bell within reach so that they can reach us anytime that they need us. And that was good.